it's been about 1 year since we finished the first ghost tapes. But we continue to search for the truth. People still aren't entirely satisfied with our findings, and neither am I. I need more. I want to try new experiments I didn't get a chance to do before. I want to try other places outside of Chicago. I want better evidence. So I'm back. My way to an investigation. It's a residential home. It will be the first residential home that we've actually investigated for something like this. And you're probably wondering, where's Jim? Well, literally the day that we ended filming of the first movie, he moved out to Colorado. Which is why we originally wanted to shoot the whole movie in Colorado this time around, but due to lack of funding, we can only afford to do some filming in Colorado, not all of it. What I'll be doing tonight is I'm going to be a guest investigator, and I'll be joining a separate paranormal group, so that's going to be interesting.
I feel like I need to ask him his permission. Can we enter his room, please?
Jason's room?
Yes.
Yeah.
I just want his permission. I don't want...
Go ahead.
I don't need you to guide me. I just need to know if it's okay.
Once we arrived at the client's house, Nancy, the psychic medium, immediately began doing a walkthrough of the house, cataloging various spirits who occupy the rooms and what they are saying to her. Not only is this my first time working with another paranormal group, but it's also my first time working with a psychic medium.
In this room, we have like the presence of a man. It feels like he sits on the bed when he's in bed. And it just feels like this man sits here and looks through that way, you know, through the closet. The spirit says that there are too many rooms in this house.
A psychic medium is defined by a person who purportedly mediate communications between spirits of the dead and other human beings.
So I feel like, I don't know if they used to argue at night, because it feels like there was just arguments taking place, and then it just feels like when you're in this one it feels like very overwhelming. The other thing that I can tell you is whoever's in this room says, we want to go home. We want to go home. We're not alone at night. And then it keeps feeling like there's frustration. It's like arguing. It's very frustrating. It is very overwhelming. The argument continues. And then he talks about the one. And he just says, while you're sleeping, and I believe it's you, because it's a woman. And it feels like when you're sleeping, you're doing astral travel. She said that she is very upset that you are in this house. And she says, why are you here? Why are you here? Why are you in our house? She wants to know, why are you here? And so I said to her, I'm here to help you. You have asked other people to come here before to help you out.
To this house? No.
Before. What the spirit is saying is that she can't believe that you asked for help again. It's like this has happened to you before.
After she finishes her rounds, she describes everything she sees and hears to the homeowner, while Rick and I begin our investigation.
Ghosts don't just operate in the dark. They don't just operate at night. However, at the same time, myself as being a sensitive, it does kind of raise my sensitivity level up just a little bit. So that's why I do it. Not because ghosts can only operate in the darkness. Most of the spirits that I've seen, light of day, man, light of day. So let's go take a look in here. a lot of times when you get a whisper, a spirit could actually be standing right next to you, yelling in your ear, but it comes across as being a whisper because it's kind of a, it's a gulf of consciousness, more or less, like this great chasm that they're trying to speak. Let me ask you something. From what we understand is that we've been told that you really just do not want us here right now. Is there any particular reason why you don't want us here? Was that you that made the tick tick sound in the bathroom here? Could you possibly make it again, please? Right over here is like a tick tick sound. Maybe you can come up to this light that I'm holding in my hand and speak in this little microphone right here. We can be able to pick up whatever it is you say. Or you can come over to this red light here and maybe you can do me a favor. Maybe you can make this little arrow thing right here go up. Or would you rather stick with the one knock for yes and two for no? One knock for yes, two for no, please. That's what I'm talking about, man. That's the stuff that makes this stuff great.
This is why you record things.
This is why you record things, you bet. Thank you for that knock, I appreciate it. Make the light. Mm-hmm. This is Rick and Luke in Chase's bedroom. From what I understand, that there is a man in this bedroom. We've been asked to come here because they want to know who you are and why you're here. Is there anybody with us now in this room, please? I'm going to do with you like I did with the person over in the other bedroom. They gave us a lot of great noise over there. I'm going to do this. I'm going to give you one knock for yes, two for no. Do you understand what I've told you? Give me one knock for yes, two for no, please.
I have an idea.
Yes, absolutely.
I've heard that you like to sit on the bed sometimes.
Oh, yeah.
Do you mind if I sit on the bed? Is that okay with you? Well, I'm going to. You can sit with me if you want.
If you're here with us right now, can you maybe touch one of us, please? We're not here to harm you. We're not here to... What's wrong?
Another thing just shot in your head.
Seriously?
Yeah. It goes into your head and then it disappears. That's the weird part.
I've never had anything like that happen before.
I think the problem is, it might not be used to having people actually trying to talk to it.
That's entirely possible, because Chase isn't able to verbally speak. Is my colleague correct here? Are you not used to this? I'm feeling very... I don't want to say lightheaded, but just... Have you seen anything, like, shoot around me?
Yeah, I just saw another ball of light.
Okay, alright, then that's most... That, I guess I am feeling it now.
Where did you feel it?
Like, right over to this side of me.
That's where it came from.
Well, there you have it, then. Here's what we're gonna do. I'm gonna use the laser pointer again.
I think this orb is fascinating, because it appears to be jumping from me to Rick.
How old were you when you moved here?
I was 3 months old when we came from Germany.
Wow.
And we moved right into the northwest side.
So you don't remember anything, then?
Nah, my mom tried to teach me a couple of words in German, but, you know, you sort of forget them over time.
Whoa.
My mom... What?
It's getting weird light shit around you.
Are you...
Whoa, that was a fast one. That just shot right out of you.
Nancy wanted to use the homeowner as a trigger object. to help her confront the spirits who keep following her family from house to house. Nancy thinks much of the events happening in the house are due to a homeowner being too curious about the paranormal, and an innocent, developmentally challenged son who acts as an amplifier because of his purity.
And so I want you to just take a deep breath, let it go, take another deep breath, and let it go. And then what I want you to do is just...
Tom.
Thank you. And what this Tom is what is Tom telling you?
Is it cold in here? He's not saying anything. I can tell that he's here, though.
I just felt the breeze.
And it's cold.
What I'm picking up is it's a man. He's about 45, 46. He is very hangry.
23.1 centigrade, 22.
He wants everybody to go away. He says that this is his house. You have stepped in his area. He doesn't want you to be here.
Yeah, it is cold in here.
Oh God, I'm sorry.
19.5 Celsius. 19.6, 19.5, 19.19.
Can I tell him that we're not going away? And
you can tell him whatever you want,
and
because this man is mad.
And we're not.
He wants to know why you're here, when you're going to go away.
We're not going
to
go away.
What is he going to do to get you more frustrated? He wants to know if he's going to slam more doors. He wants to know if you're going to stop being so stubborn. He wants to know why. He's like, why? Why did you bring him here? He said, you brought him here from the other house. This man, he's telling me that you know him. Either you worked with him, you know him. He's just like, he's angry. Rick, this man is angry. He's angry at you. He's angry at his life. He wasn't a happy person. He used to drink a lot. He used to smoke a lot. He's your dad.
Take me down to 11 degrees,
please. He's my dad?
That's your dad.
Take me down to 11 degrees, please.
I can't believe you keep doing this to me. You keep bringing him with you everywhere you go.
It's gone down 9 degrees in the last 5 minutes in this room.
I'm done. I don't want to do this.
9 degrees.
Stop taking me with you.
It just feels like,
I know.
This man is hangry. If you touch me, you'll see. It's like, I just feel like I'm hangry. But yet, you know, you wake him up.
Okay.
You wake him up. Do you understand?
Yeah.
And I just feel like he wants peace. He wants peace. He wants to rest.
Okay.
Remember what I said to you in the kitchen when you said to me, it's not me, it's my sister.
Okay.
I just feel like, you know, what he's talking about is like you guys abandoned him. Nobody cared for him. He was alone. He was, all you guys did is point his finger at him.
Yep.
All you guys did is telling him what a bad person he was, how awful he was. It's like you telling him that he couldn't be around your kids. You couldn't be around anybody. And all he did was just, there was this anger. There was just anger that is like...
My uncle.
He was left to die.
My uncle was put into a nursing home and nobody...
What?
Really, I did not go and see
6.8.
Him once he was put in the home.
I just feel like he was left to die. And that's the feeling he gives me. It's like everybody abandoned him and you left him to die. It's just, I just feel like there is a lot of physical garbage going on. She's a very, very mean. And that she's very full of anger and they're very full of frustration. This man is very angry, Rick.
Can we stop this right now? Because I'm trying to do an experiment.
Yep.
The temperature has dropped. How much? About 25 degrees.
You can feel it.
25 degrees.
Yeah, it's going to keep dropping.
Now. But it's in that corner.
It's in right over here.
Yep.
And well, I felt the bed shake.
Right over here.
Yep.
And well, I felt the bed shake.
I did too.
And I don't know if it was somebody getting on or somebody like listened to me. Mm-hmm. So
that's who listened to me, because you won't listen.
Yeah.
All right, so you're at 7.6, and there's no one else on the bed right now.
Mm-hmm. Now it's going down. I move it back over that way. There's somebody sitting over here in this corner. This is only supposed to go out a foot. In front of you, see? There's somebody sitting directly in front of me.
No vents.
Nope. Nothing. There's no breeze coming through that window right there.
And I can't really feel anything.
Sometimes you don't feel a psychic cold.
This is the first time I've ever witnessed evidence in the form of a temperature shift. The corner of the room has dropped a total of 22 degrees over the course of 10 minutes.
Is there a male here? Is there a female here?
Did you guys fight a lot? Whoa.
Is that a yes?
Yep, that was a yeah. Holy shit.
Okay, alright, dude.
Okay.
If you fought a lot, why?
Would you be willing to do a channel tonight?
We can try.
You want to try?
Which one do you want to pull in? Their uncle?
I don't want to pull in anything too personal. But they're all pretty personal, aren't they? This is not a haunted house. This is
no, it's not.
Family, isn't it?
After determining that the family was haunted rather than the house, Rick decided it was time to do a channel, where Nancy acted as a host for a foreign entity to speak through her.
Could you possibly tell me your name, please?
No. I get Fred, not Ted. And I don't believe it's right.
Why are you so angry?
They abandoned me.
How did they abandon you?
They left me in a building where nobody cared. I was put to death, pretty much. They left me in a building where people came and went. They didn't care if I sat in my thesis. There is no love. There is no care. I was abandoned.
I hope your camera just got what I just saw.
I didn't see anything.
Saw a face over hers.
I'm upset because they don't care for me. I don't want to see them happy. They didn't want to see me happy.
So the anger you feel is because... going on?
You have more than one presence in this.
Yeah,
place.
I know, I can feel it right now. Are you in pain, Nancy?
I'm okay. There is so many in here. It just feels like you opened a morgue. You want to talk to the father, you don't want to talk to the uncle. The father is the one that abused his kids, beat them down, made them feel like they were not worth it. He's the one that abandoned his family. He's the one that, you know, drank like a pig. He's the one that abused his daughter, not me. I was the one that was left alone to die.
Strange as it may sound, I do care. And I am really sorry. And if there is anything that we can do to help you move on.
What are you gonna do? Bring me peace?
You know what? I'm gonna be honest with you. I can't. And it's very rude of me to be disturbing you like this, and I apologize for that. Whoa! There's something right over here. And it wasn't the heat.
Oh, God.
Okay, we're done. We're done.
Okay.
Okay, we're done. Done. Okay. Turn off the light. Turn off the light, please.
Looking.
Thank you. We're done. Are you okay? Are you okay? Okay, we're done.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, and I'm sorry. I wish that there was some way that we could help you. When I see that kind of pain on her face, done. No more. Okay, are you okay?
I have no idea where you woke up in this house.
Oh, shit.
You have a lot of people in this house who feel a lot of pain. There's a lot of suffering. There is a lot of abandonment. There is a lot of contradicting opinions of what they did for each other. And so it's like, how do you expect them to go to rest? How do you expect them to go to peace when dignity is not given to them? And it's not you. You want to bring them to light. You want to give them respect. You want to give them understanding. But it's not you. And then the other thing that I keep feeling is like, they've done this before. You're not the first person that they brought here.
No, I know.
And he's like, you know, it's almost like they keep getting awakened. And he's like, how many times do you want to jolt them?
I think for now, I think it might be best to end this investigation.
Absolutely.
I'm not feeling right about this anymore.
I understand.
I don't feel good about it at all. I think Nancy's right. I think that we have awakened some stuff. I think sometimes in paranormal investigation, I think the human side is oftentimes forgotten. I don't ever want to go on an investigation where I feel somebody, make somebody feel like a plaything. And in a way, I felt as if I was disturbing something, a sideshow, making it a sideshow. I'm not about that. I'm not going to do that. I'm not a television ghost hunter. I'm a psychical researcher, paranormal investigator. My job is to help bring peace, and I can't bring peace to this family. I think that this is something that's going to have to take a long time, and it's going to have to be that deals with them. Spiritual, social, on a family level. If there is the pain and hurt, I can't deal with that. That's not my place. Hopefully they can.
About a month after the investigation, Rick had me as a guest on his radio show, Paranormal Underground Radio. During the interview, a very strange noise crept its way onto the airwaves that no one could identify.
Now, I noticed that in the original... What was that? Karen, did you hear that?
I heard that too.
Being a media professional, obviously I realized that this is most likely some kind of ambient noise from someone's channel, or a crossing of airway signals, or any other multitude of variables. However, the wide-eyed paranormal enthusiast in me wants to say it's an EVP of some kind, or an electronic voice phenomenon.
Was something that is that was definitely wrong. Now I noticed that in the original. What was that?
It's just so creepy. Especially how it happens just as I'm recalling some disturbing events I went through while filming the first documentary.
Yeah, you could definitely tell that there was something that is that was definitely wrong. Now I noticed that in the original. What was that?
You be the judge.
Hey guys, well, it's about that time for another submission segment. And this submission comes all the way from a man in Bosnia. Yeah, Bosnia. We're getting international now. Well, anyways, in this submission, a man set up a video camera and recorded himself playing with some strobing party lights, and something really weird pops up in the footage. Let's take a look.
So here he is, swinging these lights around, and something really weird pops up in the corner. Did you see it? It's only on screen for one frame of video. Obviously, it's impossible to tell. It could literally be anything, but this person claims that they have no idea what it is. Is it an object in the room? Is it the flashing strobe lights playing tricks with our eyes? Or is it something else? Our next investigation brings us to the Sci-Fi Cafe in Burlington, Wisconsin. And once again, I will be joining Rick Hale and Nancy Laporta. Many of the supposed hauntings behind this location possibly stems from its history of being a brothel and a Capone speakeasy. There's also a network of underground tunnels beneath the building which acted as a dumping ground for dead bodies. It's said that the spirit of a woman and her daughter haunt the basement. There's also stories of a tall, thin man in a black suit known as the Whistler who is said to appear from time to time. And there's also another female spirit in the ladies' room. We decided to begin our investigation in the basement, where the spirit of a young girl, Mary Lou, and her mother are said to haunt.
Who's down here with us right now, please? Again, I said my name is Rick, and I'm here with Luke and Nancy. Can you guys say hi?
Hello. Hi. We're here to talk to you.
We've come a little bit of a distance to say hi. And I'm kind of hoping that maybe, just maybe, you will let me take your picture. Do you like posing for pictures? I'm going to take a few pictures here, and I'm hoping that you will allow me to take your picture. Is Mary Sue present, please? Mary Sue, can you tell me how old you are, sweetheart? I have a little boy at home. He's 3 years old. I bet he would love to play with you. I bet you'd love to play with him as well. Is there a place down here that you like to hide specifically? How do you feel about all this stuff that's down here, Mary Sue? Does it frighten you at all? Does it make you feel uncomfortable? Or do you like playing with the stuff down here? Do you want to ask any questions, Luke?
I'm trying to think. I don't know. Me personally, I'm more interested in the other spirits.
Okay.
Like the Whistler or the Indian Chief. Okay. I just don't know what to say to a little girl.
Well, I tell you what, how about we do the isolation sessions now?
Okay. Who's we'll going first?
I'll go first.
Okay.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
My name is Rick. And I have come here to try and make contact with you.
Nancy told me that the spirit of an old woman named Rose haunts the ladies' room on the first floor, so we went in there while Rick stayed in the basement alone.
So now you come in here. So,
do you think there's someone here right now?
Mm-hmm. You know, just, to me she feels just like an older lady who just lived here, and you know, this is her place. So, and now you got to try out the ladies' room.
Do you have a name for her?
I'd say Rose for her.
Rose?
Yeah.
Okay.
Mary Lou, from what I understand, there's a song that you like. And I would really, really would like to sing it with you. I'm a dad. I have a little boy. His name is Theo. He's the light of my life. It's my very reason for being. And I sing this song with him before he goes to bed at night. Are you ready? You are my sunshine, my only sunshine. You make me happy
when skies are gray. That's all I know. Could you maybe come over here and sing the rest for me, please?
Okay, so I'm alone in the ladies' room now that Nancy says is haunted by a woman named Rose. And this was her space that's been taken over now. And so I think I am gonna do a little spirit box.
Okay. If you're here with me, can you make that stop? Just make it stop, please. Are you over by the stairs?
Are you in here, Rose?
Ma'am, I'm not here to do you or your daughter any harm. Thank you. Let it be noted, EMF is going off right now again. If you're causing that to do that, can you stop doing that, please? Just walk away from it for just a moment. Okay, thank you. Well, wait a second. Could you maybe come back? And make that light up again, please?
Can anyone say anything to me, please? I'm asking. Oh. Is that you, Rose?
And...
Shit. Rick is done. Alright, Rick, I'm coming for you.
Hey, Luke?
Yep?
The big camera right now ran out of tape about a minute ago.
Okay. Thanks for telling me.
Yeah.
I'll be right down.
Okay. Also, this EMF detector's been going crazy periodically on and off the entire time.
Did you feel anything weird or hear anything?
I don't know. Every once in a while, I felt what felt like a cold breeze across my face.
Mm.
But I didn't see anything, didn't really hear anything specific.
All right. I'm going to get a tape, and I'll be right down.
So now I'm finally in the basement by myself.
If there's anybody here with us right now, allow me to introduce myself. My name is Rick. And the person with me is Nancy. She is my friend.
Okay, so the story is that if you sit in this basement and you sing "You Are My Sunshine," then some little girl is gonna come up and start singing with you.
Is there a little girl that would like to come and speak to me?
If there is a woman with us right now,
you need to leave.
Are you telling me that we need to leave?
My sunshine, my only sunshine. You
be when skies are gray. You'll never know, dear, how much I loved you. Please don't take my sunshine away. In all my dreams, dear, you seem to leave me. When I awake, my poor heart pains. So won't you come back and make me happy? I'll regret it all someday.
That's fucking weird.
I'm gonna be leaving now, Rose. I will be leaving you. So, if there is anything that you would like to say, now is the time. Because I'm gathering up all my equipment here. Nothing.
Because I know she talked to him.
Oh, okay.
Well, fooey.
Hey, Luke?
Yep.
You okay?
Yep.
Time's up, man.
I know. I'm coming up now.
Okay.
After our isolation sessions in the basement, we moved to an area that is said to have a vortex of spiritual energy. This is also where the Whistler is said to be seen.
Correct?
Correct. Yeah, that's what they say.
That's what they say.
Okay.
Right away, you're getting some stuff.
Very cool.
Thank you.
Thank you. Can you stop doing that for a moment, please? All right, again, this is Rick, Luke, and Nancy. We're in the vortex area. Did you notice before that when you said the vortex area, it went off?
It went off. Every time we say vortex, it goes off. And there it goes again.
Vortex.
Try little girl.
Little girl.
Now try Whistler.
Whistler. Yeah, this one is not. This one has gone off, but it's not as sensitive.
It just goes.
Yeah.
There's nothing here that's electrical.
No, absolutely.
And now yours just pinged. Is there anything under the table?
No.
Nothing.
There's nothing here. Okay.
We gotta make it go faster.
How about a little girl? Is there a little girl here with us?
Are you feeling anything, Nancy, or are you picking anything up?
You guys, I do have company. I mean, there is an older gentleman.
Gentleman?
There's a man. There's an older man. There is a little girl.
Both of them.
You have a man in mid-20s. The only question I would have is that if that would be residual energy from people that come here.
It was at this moment when we captured a disturbing EVP with Rick's phone. He and I have both listened to the recording multiple times, and this is our interpretation.
The only question I would have is that if that would be residual energy from people that come here. Because it's similar to the little girl and the older man, I believe that they...
Not too long after it was recorded, this happened.
I just saw somebody right here. If you're here with us right now, I'm pretty sure I just saw you.
Let's answer the questions one at a time. First of all, is, you know, I believe we've already explained to them that we are here not to bother them.
No, not at all.
But to just introduce ourselves and say hi. What's so special, what is so particular about him that you are interested about him?
Yeah, you know, I mean, we're not We come here...
Did you just touch me?
I did not touch you. I'm...
I had somebody just touch my back.
I'm scratching my chin right now.
Okay, I felt like a... It was like a finger go like that.
I did not do around any such back. Thing.
Okay. Yeah, well, we're having some activity here.
Okay,
right now.
Was that you, Mr. Whistler, that just touched Rick?
Could you maybe do that again, please?
No, I'm standing really far back.
So, you asked for a name, so who are you? And, you know, it was interesting because I got John Henry.
John Henry?
Like, yes. Oh, gosh. Yes. Okay. So it's like, and it's very clear. And usually I'm not that way.
John Henry.
So their presence is very, very well known in this place.
Okay, Mr. Henry.
I heard that.
Did you hear that?
I heard that.
That was right between us.
That was right here.
It was right... Did you hear that, Nancy?
No, I'm shivering. That's why.
It was like...
So I heard that. I thought that was you.
No, dude, that was not.
The voices that Rick and I heard were not captured on any of our recording devices, but we all heard them plain as day.
I heard that again.
That was right over here.
That was right here. Oh, my God.
Says you like little things.
Well,
it's the little things that are important. It's the little things that make a difference. It's the little things that can turn into big things.
I left the room momentarily to change tapes, and while I was gone, Rick snapped some photos in the same area we heard the voices and got the EMF spikes. These are what he captured.
Well, I got something. Oh, wow. Nancy, wait till you see this.
Come in.
No.
A little girl.
It's not showing up very well, but... Ow. He's probably laughing at me right now. This street right there. Just went right through it. Where's my regular camera?
I don't know why your other camera is
closed. I don't think it's as sensitive as that thing.
So, all right, guys. Mr. Henry, I would like to say thank you very much for participating. We heard your voice. I saw you. I definitely felt you touch my back.
I heard you twice.
Yeah, exactly. Luke and I heard you twice.
So thank you and welcome.
Oh, well,
thank you very much.
So I think what we're going to do is we're going to leave this room, and we're going to leave you with all this really great stuff that's in here.
This ball just slowly drifted out of your head.
Here's a collection of evidence submitted by Chuck G. Gotsky, founder and leader of In the Dark Investigations. In this submission, they've captured some pretty interesting shadow photographs. A really creepy EVP. And finally, a pretty shocking table tipping session.
Okay, cool.
It's...
Okay. Thank you.
Holy cow.
Thank you.
Are you kidding me?
Thank you.
I want to thank Chuck for allowing us to borrow his evidence. To see more evidence or to learn more about their team, visit inthedarkinvestigations.com and keep the lights off.
Okay, so here we are with our new segment called Debunking with Jim. And making his return from the first documentary is Jim the Skeptic. How are you doing, Jim?
Doing real well, thanks.
Thanks for doing this for us.
Anytime, man.
And so what we're going to do is I'm going to walk you through a couple of bits of evidence that we got from the first movie.
Okay.
And I want to get your fact of the matter opinion. So the first thing we're going to be watching is the Google Ghost.
Okay.
An alleged photograph of an apparition that was captured by a moving Google.
Okay, by what? Car. Right, right. Photos can be altered so easily. All it takes is one innovator who's one step ahead of everybody else on Photoshop. Yes. If photographs prove anything, it's that people commit fraud. Mm-hmm. Because there are so many debunked photos out there versus the ones that haven't been explained yet.
Let's rule out fraud just hypothetically okay. for a second. Let's pretend it is a camera malfunction. A, wouldn't we see way more examples of it given the amount of photos it has to take every single day?
If you researched into it, you'd find more than just this one. I mean, people haven't looked at every... Google is trying to record every square foot of Earth, and there's only so many people with an internet connection who are spending their time looking at Google Earth.
But then, if also talking about a malfunction, don't you think the placement of the malfunction is a bit coincidental?
Why would the likelihood of coincidence more likely than a supernatural explanation? And the answer is always yes. We live in a universe controlled by coincidence.
Okay, now this next one we're going to look at is obviously plenty of room for coincidences or malfunctions, but there's still that small shadow of a doubt in me.
Absolutely.
Because I've practiced with this... with this device a lot, and I know what it does. And so we'll just take a look and then we'll talk about it.
Is there anyone here that wants to talk to us? I don't know what that was. Did it just say watch it?
Now pause it a second. This is important with both of those lines. You yourself had to ask, did it just say watch it? And when you said it aloud, it reinforced in your mind that it was watch it. And you came up with me. Is that when I heard it, it sounded more like beep. These are what skeptics would call a situational enhancement. You're in a situation where, A, you're looking for ghosts, so you're keyed up. B, you're in a creepy location, so you're a little more creeped out and keyed up. And now sounds are coming from your detector and you are making the leap of what those words actually say.
That's the point I'm making to you. Regardless of what it's saying or what I think it's saying, it's too much. Because of the sweep rate, it shouldn't be allowing us to hear that much of a word or a phrase.
Listen to these again really, really objectively in a calmer setting, just on the headphones, just by themselves, and see if you reach the same word conclusions.
That makes sense.
Okay.
And then this is everyone's favorite. Obviously, I know what you're saying. It's a malfunctioning camera.
Yep.
Yeah.
It's a malfunctioning camera, it's
but what a malfunction.
Yeah, I mean, it's like, but again, when cameras malfunction, they're going to be dramatic like that because they're altering an image. And again, it's very natural for human beings to see that blob because that's what it is. It looks like a person. Our brain is trained to make people out of things, is trained to make faces out of things. Patterns. Exactly. That's what a huge portion of our brain is just dedicated to, is making that sort of understandable order out of something. If you turn your angle of where you're taking that photo, even like 3 degrees, that might look like a bush.
A vanishing bush.
It might look like a flash of light. It might look like a whole lot of other things. But at this angle and this timing, we interpret that as a human body. It's kind of your job, if you're going to do this sort of research, to know every single way that this can mislead you and every single thing that can go wrong.
I guess that's part of the problem, because I am a video major. I'm pretty familiar with the kind of problems that cameras can go
Absolutely.
Through. And it's never usually so well integrated with the photo. It's
right.
Usually has something to do with the entire picture or nothing at all.
Sure.
So that's where it gets really complicated for me. All right, guys, that has been Debunking with Jim. Jim, Thanks again.
My pleasure, Lou.
Any closing words?
No. I think I've said it all.
Everything we've worked so hard for has been leading up to this point. Now is the time to finally begin my journey to Colorado. To meet up with an old face and to investigate a new state.
So here we are, back together again. You excited for the shoots coming up?
Yes, sir. I'm excited to go out and investigate these locations that we've been working so hard to get lined up.
Especially with Stanley.
Stanley's going to be a good investigation. It's going to be a good experience.
Rather than a submission of a single piece of evidence, I want to take a minute or so to present an entire collection of amazing photographs, taken by Rita Strugala, who has been documenting and investigating the paranormal for 38 years. This is only a small handful of the shocking images she sent me. I actually had to pick some from a much larger pile of photos. To see more evidence by Rita or for more information on her group, visit southernparanormal.org. Getting to the destination was no easy task. After having our car break down, and being delayed 3 hours later, and our contact no longer working at the location, it seems many things have tried to stop us from coming. Thank you.
Well, here we are, finally, at the legendary and historic Stanley Hotel in Estes Park, Colorado. The very direct inspiration for The Shining. Now, Stephen King actually stayed in room 217 when he wrote The Shining, which is the actual haunted room that Stanley Kubrick changed to 237 for the film. Why he did that, no one really knows, but unfortunately, room 217 is the only room we will not be seeing, but the entire property is granted access to us for our investigations tonight. And I have chills. I can't wait. I've been trying to come here for years, and now we're here. You ready to get started, Jim? All right, let's do this.
Just for the fun of it, we decided to sign up for the famous haunted tours of the Stanley, but we actually got some really weird things. On the tour, Jim's camera phone would often begin taking photos all by itself without him pushing the button.
That pig took a picture without me taking a picture.
The what?
The camera went off without me shooting it.
Did it?
I swear.
Get that flash going.
So everybody would like to welcome you to the lower level of the concert hall, or what I affectionately call the basement. If you are video recording.
Okay, so we're on the Stanley Hotel ghost tour right now, and yeah, I got a sticker on my head. Rules. And Jim's camera keeps taking photos all by itself.
And every so often, it would actually catch something. This is the first I've ever heard of a spirit catching itself.
Anyone else want to go first?
Oh, I'll go first. Don't be behind that. Is there anyone in here that can talk to us, please?
Can you make my beeper go off?
Or our new meat cake 2 go off? I'm gonna be in here for a minute. Record show that I can actually see dust in front of my camera, but it's not being picked up by the lens. Jim snapping photos up on the balcony. There goes another one of those things. See, I am seeing dust, but it's not picking up on the lens, so I don't know what those things are. Really cool. I'm constantly, look, we can see the dust, and it's not picking up. So whatever is shooting is not dust. Okay, so we just got back from the tour, and I just set these meters on the bed, and they were not going off. And now they're both... One's getting a little...
One's raging.
Yeah, that kid too is raging. Oh, fuck.
Now it's chilling.
And now it's gone. Now that's impressive.
That blew my mind.
Thank you. If that was you, can you do that again for us, please?
I heard that one make noise.
Yeah, that one twitched, which we both know never
super
does.
Super sensitive.
Oh,
there we go.
Shit. Thank you. It's like we can't even properly start because everything just happens right away. Well, that was strange. So here we are, in the
tunnels.
After the tour, Jim and I finally begin our official investigation in the rock tunnels underneath the hotel.
Is there anyone down here that would like to talk to us, please? We just want to talk to you.
Tap on the doors, the walls.
We hear there's a man at the end of this hall that likes to peek around the corner.
What's your name, Bill?
Can you peek around that corner for us, please? Can you tell us your name, please?
Did you die down here, Bill?
Alright, I'm gonna turn on the spirit box. Maybe we can hear him. Maybe we won't.
We're going to turn on this device here, Bill, see if you can talk to us.
If you're down here with us, can you please tell us your name?
What's your name, Bill? Why is your stairway so haunted?
There's not a thing coming through this right now. Did you die in this hotel? This is the first time we haven't heard a single thing on this.
I know.
If you want us to leave, just say so and we will go.
Whoa. Can you say that again?
Can you please repeat that?
He's back in here. He's in there. Whoa,
what? Whoa, whoa, what?
Big orb right by your head.
After a couple of years of seeing dust, bugs, and orbs, and other strange lights, this one blows them all away. Not only does it move in the strangest pattern I've ever seen, it's also not in any kind of recognizable shape.
I think we're seeing you. So we want to hear you, too.
I can feel you. Are you around me?
I'm getting chills right now.
Are you down here with me?
Or maybe you could tell us what year you died.
Or what your name is.
We'd love to know your name. I know he's something.
Do you have a family?
Okay, something just shot into your head.
Are you with Jim right now? I feel like a draft on my neck. Am I sitting right in front of this big hole? Yeah, I am. Let's see this hole. Is there anyone in this hole that wants to talk? Okay, now that is what dust looks like.
Whoa. Yeah.
Why are you so afraid of us? We have no means of harming you in any way.
Have you talked to us yet? Maybe we can't hear you. Can you talk a little louder to us?
Spirit box, last time, I promise.
Why is there a dead zone down here? Holy cow.
What? I've never heard it do this. Could be batteries. Are you messing with my stuff right now? Are you mad that we're trying to talk to you? Let me try this battery trick again. Are you messing with my stuff right now?
Sounds like jungle techno.
Ooh, did you hear that? It said something. Was that you? You finally gonna come out and talk to us? Are you good or evil? Make you mad that we're down here? Holy shit! Did you just hear it say yeah? It said yeah. I don't think he's happy that we're here. I heard you.
I can feel you.
And we're feeling you again. Okay. Now, you told us you don't want us in your space, so guess what? We're gonna leave. Just for you. Does that make you happy?
Does it upset you that tons of people come looking for you all the time?
He did say we're bothering him. I think we should leave now.
I can feel him right around me.
We're gonna honor your wishes, and we're gonna leave now.
Honestly, dude, I can feel it right up on me.
Just because you said yeah, we will now get out of your space.
I can feel it up on me.
We're gonna leave, Jim. Lights going on. Oof. I have such a headache right now. Oh. Okay. So what we have going on behind me is something that they call instrumental transcommunication. And you can do it with pretty much anything, but right now we're doing it with a camera that's being fed its input into the TV, and then we have it aimed at the TV, creating this infinite picture effect. And they say that sometimes spirits can show themselves in this, so we've got this thing going here. I'm trying to get it to do something. Sometimes you have to move it around and make it do different things. Oh, there we go. That's what I'm talking about. And behind Jim, we have our infrared trail camera that's been snapping photos all day.
Kiefer Thomas, the desk clerk and night auditor at the hotel, was gracious enough to take us to other rooms on the property, and even investigated with us. The billiard hall has an American flag hanging in it that features a prominent face of Mr. Stanley himself slowly being burned into the stripes.
If there's anyone here with us, can you please walk in front of these lights? It won't hurt you.
I know we had some shadow photos of you guys.
Are you here with us? If you're here, could you make a tapping on the count of three? One, two, three. There's a chair right there you can go sit in.
Yeah.
There's a little green light. Can you make that go to yellow? Make that light go to yellow on that chair. We promise we'll leave you alone and we'll leave.
We'll leave right now.
That's a deal.
Are you in here with us? Said I do. Did you hear that?
My camera had run out of tape before this voice could be recorded, but luckily I also had an audio recorder rolling.
You want us to leave or to stay?
Stuff in here. I've heard a lot of things in this building, both by myself and in front of groups. So that's why I like coming in here.
So this is where we were earlier on our tour, but now we are getting VIP access.
So I told the guys, hold on, I'm saying I'm just gonna go shut the light off.
Mm-hmm.
So. Now we're up here, I'm gonna open up the door to turn off the light. I got about right here in the door, did that.
Shit.
I actually jumped and I screamed.
Wow.
I don't know. I don't know what it was.
Hmm.
I had to excuse myself and walk in here by myself and catch my breath, because it's not what I expected.
I don't know.
We're coming down here, Lucy. After that ghost hunt was finished, Connor and I were sitting over here in some chairs.
Mm-hmm.
We were talking quietly. He's like, Connor, you hear that? I shit you not. I mean, down here in the hallway, you could hear footsteps. Somebody been walking.
Oh.
And it was just us in the building at that time.
Are you here with us? Can you talk to us, Lucy?
Where are the little kiddos? The kid ghosts.
You want to shut the door for us? I can hear it.
You can hear it?
Big time.
Just one little push.
Can you hear that, Luke?
Lucy, if you close that door, I will give you some candy. Any kind you want.
How about you just shut the door for us? I hear you wanting to shut it.
I can hear that rattling noise.
That's the hinges, bro.
I can get over there. If I can hear it, then that's freaking loud. Holy shit. It's moving right now. Lucy, is that you? Can you please close that door for us?
And?
We just want to be friends. Maybe it's not Lucy.
Maybe it's Charlie or Bill.
Whoever you are, we would love to have that door closed.
Oh shit. Oh shit. Oh shit.
Jesus Christ. Holy cow. Did you just close that door?
Personally, I'm not sold on the notion that this door closing is anything paranormal, but countless witnesses at the hotel claims that some days the door will remain open, and other days it'll just close continuously, so I'm not sure. You're gonna have to be the judge on this one.
Were you up there the whole time?
I've been all over the place.
Okay. We heard footsteps, and we're just wondering if that was you or something else.
Could have been me. I mean, I've been walking all over the place.
Alright, I have not been up there yet. I'm coming up. They said this, what was this, like a private booth?
Yeah. We're gonna go sit down. If you want to open that door, or make a knock, so we know you're with us, that would be very appreciative.
Did it light up?
Yeah. Three lights.
Missed it.
Thank you very much.
Whoa. Yep.
Oh my God.
There it goes. Thank you very much.
So let's do this. Make the lights light up for us for yes. And don't do anything for no.
Do you understand?
Do you want us here? Do you want us to go?
Cool. Okay. Oh, you heard him.
Yeah.
Okay.
We understand.
We'll be leaving your space now. Okay, all right, okay.
We're going. Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Sorry to have bothered you. Okay, well, that's all I need. Jim, we're leaving. Same. That's the same thing that happened in the tunnel. That was same the thing. Only voice we got through the spirit box. Do you want us to leave? And it said, yeah. So we're gonna keep.
You know, there's one of the things I've always I can't. It kind of ticks you off, and the more you do this, you know, you ghost hunt, you sit in a creepy place, mm-hmm. you ask these questions. Do you want us to go? Do you want us to go? Can you do something? When something does happen, people freak out and they run. Mm-hmm. You know? Didn't you just ask the spirit if they could communicate to you?
Yeah.
And now you're leaving? You know, you gotta think. To me.
I only leave when they ask me to.
It's rude, you know?
Yeah.
Unless you want them to stay there.
Yeah.
You know? But I don't know. I mean, I can understand being scared a little bit because it's natural, but if you're inviting and asking,
and then you run, that's pretty rude.
Yeah.
It works.
The final building that Kiefer took us to was the carriage house, a building seen by very few. This is a place that they don't even take the tour groups. A building usually reserved for other big-name ghost hunters and camera crews.
Yeah, be careful of the floor.
It's a tiny little place.
The wind just picked up really good for us, huh?
Ooh, it's really cold in here. It definitely feels weird in here. Okay, so I got this thing on.
Will you talk to us?
It's freezing in here.
It's colder in here than it is outside. That always is not a good sign.
What's your name?
Do you have a name? Oh. Said something. Hello? We can hear you. Is it okay that we're in here with you? What's your name?
Eva.
What did it say?
That said Eva.
Are you good or evil? It is way cold in here. Why is it so cold in here?
If you make a knock or tapping, we will go. That is a promise. So on the count of three, make a knock or tapping or touch one of us.
Or make the batteries go dead on my green light.
One, two, three.
Is that you, Jim?
Yeah.
That no, you? That's something near me.
But that was not you.
That was
thought. Well.
You heard that too, then.
Yeah, I heard it, and it. Jim says it wasn't him. I believe him.
I didn't move.
Okay. Well, shit.
This is the fourth time in a single night that a spirit has requested us to leave a specific room or area by responding to our questions of whether they wanted us there or not.
Does it make you mad that we're down here?
You want us to leave or to stay?
Do you want us to go?
Well,
if you make a knock or tapping, we will go. That is a promise.
Green light.
One, two, three.
Okay, so we are finally actually investigating our own room. This is a room where people feel like someone is tucking them in at night. And I guess a lot of people end up leaving before the night is even over. Is that right, Jim?
Yep. I'm not scared.
I'm not scared. And we got this trail camera that's been shooting continuously the entire day. So I can't wait to see what's been going on. So Jim's pretty tuckered out. He's gonna let the ghost tuck him in tonight. But I wanted to burn...
I got a few rocks in my shoes too.
You got a few rocks in your shoes? Yeah, we saw so much more of the Stanley than I ever thought we would. So I guess I'll just go in the bathroom and do an EVP session or something.
Okay, so this is our bathroom. Is there anyone here in our room with us? I'd love to talk to you, if you don't mind. Can you please make this meter in my hand light up? You've done it out in the bedroom plenty of times. Or maybe you're gone and visiting someone else now. Are you gonna tuck us in after we go to bed? That would be really weird.
Jim?
Yep.
Any closing words of the night before we get tucked in by what's your name? So, I guess I will check in with you guys tomorrow morning on whether or not Jim and I have been tucked in or not. Right, Jim?
Got it. Bedtime.
Bedtime.
This has been the most fascinating and chilling investigations we have ever been on in our entire life. Though all of the paths in the road seemed to want to stray us away from our destination, we made it, and experienced a night neither of us will ever forget.
And so, finally wraps up Ghost Tapes 2. I can't even begin to describe how amazing all this filming has been. And I want to especially thank Chuck and his crew, and Rick and Nancy for all their support and help, and just, it's been a blast. And coming out to Colorado and seeing Jim again has been an amazing reunion at such a historic location. What do you think is the coolest thing that happened at the Stanley?
Well, there's a lot of history there. From our time with the hotel staff, I found out that there's quite a few teams that go there. And I guess the thing that is most interesting to me about the Stanley is how many people have actually had experiences there, and
it's a lot.
It's a hotbed for paranormal activity. So to be at such an amazing location, a historic location, I guess that was the thing that impressed me the most about Stanley.
But what do you think is the strongest piece of evidence we caught while we were there?
Evidence. while I was walking around on our ghost tour,
I saw that my camera would just randomly shoot pictures.
Just by itself, it would take pictures.
And it's never done that to me before. So I would have to say that part.
Especially catching things while it's taking pictures.
It was actually taking photos of actual evidence.
Yeah.
So I'd say that would probably be my most compelling part of our investigation at the Stanley.
I'd have to say that too. And I just want to thank you all for watching and your continued support. And I want to thank the Stanley Hotel for allowing us to investigate. And they have a great staff. And this has all just been so amazing. Do you have any last words?
Well, I was interested to know what you thought about your experience at the Stanley.
It was a very strange building. There's a lot of different energy in different rooms that we went in. But towards the end of the night, like around 4 o'clock in the morning, and the whole building was empty. It,
everyone was sleeping.
We just felt like we were at home suddenly. It's just a very strange atmosphere there. So thanks for watching, guys, and stick around for Ghost Tapes the series.
We look forward to bringing you guys more investigations and sharing the paranormal world with you.
So thanks for your support, guys.